You come over here.
Good sunny morning, everybody, from Crossroads Chapel. It's Brother Bucky, and I'm trying to get some fellow churchgoers here online with us. Say hello, Miss Stevie. Hey, listen, you know what I was thinking about today? Game shows. Who doesn't love a good game show? You guys like game shows?
I love game shows.
All right. No whammies, right?
No.
All right. Well, here's the deal. I'm going to give you an opportunity to not get any whammies. And I think the longest running game show ever was The Price is Right. And there's nothing like the exhilaration of when Bob Barker would go, and you get a chance to win a new car. Hey, how about if I told you that I had an absolutely foolproof way for you to get a brand new car? Would you be in? I bet you would be in on that. And the reason that I say that is that who wouldn't want a new car, right? I mean, even if you have a new car, if you had no strings attached, an opportunity to get a new car, who would not sign up for that? Here's what I'm going to tell you. The price is right. The price has been paid for us. And that price was the sacrifice that God gave his only son in Jesus Christ, that he would go to the cross and die for the propitiation, for our sins, that he would be the sacrificial lamb for our sins. Now, where am I going with sins? Where am I going with this as it relates to a game show? I was thinking about this coming in this morning. If I told you that I had a foolproof way for you to be able to navigate the storms of life. And when I say navigate, that doesn't mean go around them, but to actually go through and around them. Sometimes you want to go around them, sometimes you go right through them. I admire those hurricane hunters. My wife said she'd love to be on a hurricane hunter plane. And then I saw the video. I don't know if you saw the video of Hurricane Milton. Man, I got no interest in getting in a hurricane plane. No chance at all. But here's the deal. The Bible tells us that Jesus had spoken to his disciples and said, hey, get in the boat, we're going to the other side. And they did that. They were obedient. They got in the boat and they were headed to the other side. Then a storm rose. And that storm was, the Bible calls it a tempest. And I would imagine that you all out here, we've all experienced a tempest or two in our life that was not pleasurable. But they thought they were going to die. And where was Jesus? He was taking a nap. So I affectionately call it nap 30. The middle of this storm, and Jesus was taking a nap, and these guys are like, yo, dude, get up. They said, hey, we're going to die here, and you're taking a nap. And Jesus spoke to the storm. He rebuked the winds, and the calm set in. And these guys were like, huh? They couldn't believe it. They're like, what manner of man is this that even the winds and the rains, that everything is subject to him? Here's what I'm trying to tell you. Here's my point to this whole thing. Do you know that Jesus Christ gave us the power to tread on serpents and scorpions? That through the name of Jesus, all things are subject to the name of God. When you call out his name, and that includes the storms of your life, because we walk by faith and not by sight. And I am not telling you that there aren't going to be some storms that are difficult to navigate and to get through. But I'm telling you this, that you'll get to the other side if your faith is in Jesus. But that takes work. Now, I'm not talking about a works-based salvation. Listen, sometimes we got to roll up our sleeves. You can't just, you know, we've had a bunch of trees down here from Hurricane Milton and Helene. Listen, you got to get out there and whip out the chainsaw and cut that thing up, man. Work has to be done. It takes an effort to get through these storms, but Jesus Christ is there with you. So the next time you go through a storm, ask yourself, would I rather go through the storm or take a nap? Because that's really what it seems like when Christ is with you. Not that you won't struggle. Surround yourself with people that will build you up, lift you up, encourage you through that storm. Man, I promise you this. That is a promise from God. That there is, if you made the decision today to trust God, to ask him, to receive him into your life as your Lord and Savior, you have an opportunity to navigate through every single storm from here to eternity with safety and comfort and a peace that surpasses all understanding. I hope you grab hold of some of that. Listen, we're going to be back here in about 20 minutes with some awesome praise and worship. Set the table early this morning, and man, was it good. And then right into Pastor Scott's word after a brief intermission for our collection of tithes and offerings, which, listen, if you're not tithing an offering to your local body, to where God is feeding you, that's a biblical injunction. And we always say we don't need your money. God provides for us, but it is a biblical injunction to support where you are fed. So I want to encourage you to do that. If you're not part of a local body, get in, get involved. That's what God's design is for you. So I love you all, and I hope to see you back here very shortly. Have a great day.